am I? What do I do in the band?
Steve Dan's drums.
My name's Mike and I play guitar.
Touch your brand new body and you say,
hey. I'm Boris. I'm the bass player and the source of inspiration.
I'm Katie Cunningham, the singer in the rock band Death Mask. Death Mask, the rock band.
Death Mask is rock and roll.
We're a rock and roll band.
Death Mask is an awesome rock band.
Death Mask is a band that I play in.
Death Mask makes you feel young again and very, very pretty.
And that's what Death Mask is.
Steve says Mike and I had a dream.
Oh, it formed from the earth.
I remember asking Boris if he wanted to play in the band, and he said yeah.
First there was Boris, who knew Steve back in the 90s and probably also the 80s.
We got together. We had worked on some projects together in the past. We got together and wrote a couple of songs.
And then Steve somehow knew Michael from probably also the 90s.
Boris and Mike started it, I think.
And we brought in Katie to see if she could sing on them.
We tried her out. Katie was awesome.
And I knew Boris from the 90s at Syracuse.
And then Steve was always there, a friend of ours. I don't think he wanted to play drums at first because he had like three bands. And we kind of talked him into playing.
Got Katie and then got me.
And then we got together in the 2000s.
And we all rock, and I like the way it all sounds together.
And each year has gotten better and better since we all formed, since we all turned into one.
Oh, so where did we get the name Death Mask?
The name Death Mask came from an incident that Katie experienced early on.
I don't know.
Katie went and saw an exhibit at a museum. I believe her friend was curating or something.
One day, I went to a museum where my friend worked, and she took me in some of the secret back rooms.
There's something with Katie and a museum.
And there was the African death mask.
It's like an African death mask or something. She looked at it and
she took me to one room of death masks, and she said, "You shouldn't look at these, but I do sometimes. I'm gonna..."
You're not supposed to look at them, but I do.
They're supposed to be cursed if you see them.
And so I looked at one.
And she went and looked at them anyway. Later on that day,
I went to my job, and then a stiff wind came up from the north or some other direction, and it blew the only tree on the block down, probably the only tree in New York.
A tree uprooted from the ground, then fell on top of her.
And it hit me. And I lived.
She had to go to the hospital where I retrieved her.
And there's a song called Forest on our hit CD, Evildoers, that is kind of about that day.
And there's a line in it about how a tree fell on Kathleen and it didn't make a sound.
Not exactly about that day, but an imagined version.
Tree fell on Kathleen.
And that's when we said, Death Mask is the name.
What do I see as my vision of Death Mask in the future?
I don't think I have a specific vision musically.
I'd like to play a big shows tour and...
Hopefully we'll make it big, big, big.
Rock the world?
Well, I only see... good things, bigger and better and more awesome songs and pervier songs, darker and brighter too.
Dream is we all can keep playing together and travel around the world and play Death Mask music.
Well, I got us all some books about making it in the music industry, so we're gonna hunker down and read those books.
I just wanna, keep making albums, maybe movies.
we're planning to carve out our own way and not get discovered by any douchebags. I think our sound is,
it's like nothing you've ever heard.
I always have a hard time describing the sound of the band.
It's eclectic. It's changed from each album.
It's getting happier and happier.
Sometimes really progressive.
Not metal.
Sometimes poppy.
And I always say the best compliment that we get is that we don't sound like anybody specific.
It's more about songwriting than it is musicianship, I would say, even though all the players are great. I've been so good. It's all that we've been. Influences, I think, are pretty different from one member to the next.
They're really wide-ranging. Everybody's got sort of eclectic tastes.
I grew up liking metal.
I like funk and hip-hop and electronica.
I like a lot of film music.
You know, everything from metal to country, rap.
Well, my sister and my dad, they're really good songwriters.
Right now, I think I like rock more than anything.
I just try to compliment everything that's going on, and I think that's the most you can do.
When we're playing our songs, do I envision something? I don't think so, man.
I don't think so. I don't know that I pay attention too much about what I'm thinking about.
Maybe people dancing sometimes.
Has somebody else already said Boris naked? No. I don't.
I have to say all the songs are different, so I get a different feeling from each one.
What do I visualize? I should try to psych myself up or out.
I guess maybe I visualize the song being played well. That's probably about it.
Cookies? No.
The process is, I think, has stayed pretty much the same throughout.
I will think of a pervy topic.
Katie will start off with some lyrics.
We're a very happy topic.
Where Katie writes the lyrics and she comes to us and sings them.
Or a topic about dead people. And think of a little melody or jingle.
Me and Boris usually figure out the some harmonies, like the chords that go along with it.
And melody ideas.
Talk about the style and how we want it to sound, and then we go from there. And usually the last thing is to bring it to Steve.
Usually that's when they come to my house and I come up with a beat for it. Or sometimes they have ideas for beats.
And he hits things.
So it kind of evolves. It gets awesomer and awesomer.
And I think it allows everybody to have their own voice in it, because it's not somebody coming with a complete song, but instead it's created together as a group. Oh, I won't ask where we're going.
I won't ask for one more day. Me and Steve, we're in another band called the Lifeguards.
South Jersey Seashore Lifeguard Convention Band. Rented this house last summer and recorded an album in it.
And I just came as a visitor and a debaucher.
And we just liked it. It's a good house. It sounds good. And Death Mess wanted to do the same thing.
But this time it's all biz.
And we wanted to, sequester ourselves and try to complete most of an album in a week.
So it worked out real good for us last time, and we're doing it this time.
It's beautiful, the location. It's on a lagoon.
Oh, it's a beautiful lagoon house.
Right next to Long Beach Island.
I'm looking out the window right now. I see some water.
There's an awesome deck out back.
We got the salty ocean, wintertime, peacefulness.
I see a lot of docks and sand, and it's sunny out right now, but it is cold.
I thought it was going to be freezing, but I think just because my house in Brooklyn is so freezing.
And it's quiet.
It's quiet around here.
It's very peaceful. I'm enjoying that aspect.
But it's delightful. Totally nice.
It's nice. It lets you, focus.
And a water view makes all the difference to everyone's feng shui. and mindset. Well, I kind of got thrown off. I don't like to miss 1 minute of a party, and I didn't get to come here until they had already been established. So they kind of started off with some bad habits.
Daily routine for this recording session.
What we do is we get up in the morning.
It involves some late sleeping generally. Steve being the last one to rise.
Then it takes about an hour or so for Steve Dance to get ready.
There's coffee, cigarettes.
And we do our easy Pilates.
Pilates, which was an unexpected twist.
Eat breakfast, oatmeal, something healthy, which Katie has us on a strict regimen of health foods.
Oatmeal, again, unexpected for me.
So we didn't really get into a routine of Pilates oatmeal. I want to do Master Cleanser for lunch, but we've just been having whatever.
Have some Red Bull.
There's lots of recording during the day.
And then we start recording until about 8 o'clock.
And a delicious dinner at night.
I thought you might like chicken wings and macaroni and cheese. And then delicious dinner.
Maybe a few drinks.
And fine red wine. And they've been having a lot of White Russians on gambling.
And then it's time for cards, which Boris has won every night almost.
Some cards, and then
we continue to get drunk until we pass out.
And then we go to bed, and then we wake up and do the same thing again.
Back to recording.
You waste my time. party. We'll blow my candles out and smash piñatas. Lead baby brother home, he don't get us. Our candy hearts throw home in my backyard.
A lot of the times, I don't really know what the lyrics are until we record the album. Yeah, I have been picturing the story in my head while we're playing it, which you know, I guess that's what I envisioned. Some of it's kind of perverted, you know, like some of it's kind of perverted. Other stuff is like love stories. Older songs were like just stories. I don't know, detectives and shit like that.
Well, as far as the songs, I think my favorite thing about the songs is that they're all sort of stories that everybody can have their own interpretation of, and I like that. I think I get tired of songs that are very literal and trying to put some sort of philosophy on you. I like the fact that the songs are open to interpretation and everybody can sort of decide what it means to them, and if they can find something that moves them or they find powerful about it, That's enough.
Katie would be the best to ask for that, because they all are very deep within her psyche, and I think a lot of them have to do with her childhood.
I don't know if I should share any insight. Brainwash Me or Stranger is about Mike Bishop's right hand or left hand, as it relates to being in a cult leaders. It's kind of two different disparate ideas and then fused into one. My coworker recently joined a cult, and so I kind of imagined that as it relates to Mike Bishop's right hand.
Now that I'm deranged, now that we're one and the same, I came too fast but stayed too late.
Tico is inspired by recent Super 8 footage found of my birthday party. And really, there's this guy Tico, and he had a little brother, John Paul, and I was like a tiny baby. I don't remember them at all, but we just kind of imagined that I love Tico and hate his little brother. But it wasn't the case. It's just fiction.
Time!
Phenomenon is about Phenomenon d'amour. Was inspired by a play at my JOB where I walked into the first rehearsal. It's called Phenomenon. I walked into the first rehearsal and I saw these two characters like about to make out. And I'm like, no, we shouldn't, in the diegesis of the play. And then I'm like, oh my gosh, this is a perverted play, because the two actors kind of looked exactly alike and I thought they were brother and sister. But no, they shouldn't make, they're like, no, we shouldn't, but for some other reason, because they were co-workers in the play, not because they were brother and sister. And so that's kind of how that came about, Phenomenon d'amour. About making out with your own brother in the suburbs because there's too much seismic activity. Oh, Danielle, the song is kind of my friend Danielle and I, who I went to college with, who I met kind of the same time as Poor, was going through a hard time last year, and I was kind of going through a similar hard time. I mean, we are having very different hard times, but kind of going through the changes together. And so it was kind of an inspirational song. She was kind of inspired by her and her struggles and her overcoming, although probably just as much by my own. Flame in the Wave is kind of a song about total dysfunctional relationships, and how you kind of, the two totally wrong people for each other kind of become dependent, like drugs. Pavana 1, 2, 3. Oh, Crawl Pavana 1 probably won't make it on to the CD, but that's where Crawl Pavana and I are just kind of getting to heaven. Crawl Pavana 2 is about kind of the ride up while we're going to heaven, and incidents leading up to going to heaven. Then Crawl Pavana 3 is we've been up there and we're seeing each other again and we're reminiscing about our time on land. Pavano, but it's about happy. It's kind of about being raptured up to heaven, but in a scientific way. Something changes in the environment. It's the first time.
one thing that comes to mind, like I could always think of, there's a song called Bums, and I just picture a band playing that at a high school dance in the 80s. I always picture a scene from Better Off Dead when he goes to the high school dance and there's a band playing.
Yes. Well, and it might also be played in, a school dance in the 3000s, who knows? It's great for kids.